The Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation has launched its first national photography competition with the theme, It's More Fun in the Philippines. PAGCOR will choose 12 winning images that show people, customs, natural or historical landmarks in the Philippines. The images will be used by the Department of Tourism for its various promotional materials. The best entries will also be used for PAGCOR's 2014 calendar. The contest will run until May 20, 2013. And joining us here in the studio to tell us more about this and how they are using social media to spread the word is a familiar face for all of us, MARICAR Bautista, now Assistant Vice President for Corporate Communications of PAGCOR. Hi, MARICAR. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, TJ.
Good to see you. Yeah. All right. Well, tell us about this program. It's not the usual thing that we hear PAGCOR doing.
Yes.
It's quite novel. But tell us about why you guys decided to put up a photo competition and with this particular theme.
Okay. First and foremost, one of the mandate of PAGCOR is to help boost tourism.
Right.
So we are doing our share in helping the campaign of the Department of Tourism, and that is It's More Fun in the Philippines, which is indeed really more fun in the Philippines. So the chairman, Christina Negat, thought of coming up with ways on how we can help, and we started with it last year when we thought of coming up with the first PAGCOR National Art Competition.
Okay.
Also for our designs in our 2013 calendar, and it was indeed quite successful.
And that was for art. That was for like
paint
and whatever other mediums. Was there charcoal and oil canvas? Okay, all right.
And we received good feedback.
Okay.
And a lot of entries, and so we thought of why not try photography, and with just a few days, we have received several entries already.
Yes. And this should be more fun, well, pun intended, because everybody has a camera now.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't require an SLR. I mean, you can take a really good photo with your phone.
Just like
if you. I try. I mean, if you're lucky with a good shot, with a good image, good lighting, it can be done with a simple device. So all the more, it opens the spectrum of people to join, right?
Yes.
And it's interesting that this was a big hit. Remember when the DOT brought this out? It was a big hit with the memes online, and people are doing whatever they wanted to with the hashtag, and then they'll put in their graphics. And are you trying to jump off from this, from the popularity of that already? And of course, obviously, the unity this brings and the national pride it brings of promoting our country as well.
Yeah. There's a wealth of tourist attractions that some are not even tapped. So, for you, for instance, or even like our fellow reporters, they've been around. Not many people do see what they saw.
Yep.
So, it's one way of informing the public that hey, might as well visit this place, this part of the country where you can actually enjoy or have fun.
Exactly. And that's why you make it nationwide. So it's open to anybody from Apari to down south.
Right.
So if they feel so proud about this particular, you know, hidden waterfall, it's not so known, and they can make a beautiful picture out of it, that's one way for them not just to join the contest, but to promote it as well.
Yeah, I just noticed that most competitions only cover Metro Manila. So why not extend it, let's say, to Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao.
Yes, why not? Yeah. I mean, I wonder why the others did that. Maybe it's a cost problem of flying in the winners, if ever, or something like that. Or, well, nowadays you can email the photo. I guess before, olden days, you'd have to print out the whole, you know, structure and size
and bring
it physically. Mm-hmm. So that's a challenge. So for now, tell us about the requirements. Of course, there are categories and as well as criteria for the photos that they will be submitting.
Okay. First, there are four categories. First would be about people.
Okay.
That may include portrait. What else? Human interest or scenes from just everyday life. Except pictures or photos of politicians. That is strictly prohibited.
All right. So even if, let's say, their favorite mayor or barangay captain is in the middle of a fun fiesta mood, kahit maganda photo, it's a no-no.
They can always find other subjects.
Yeah, of course they do. But I'm just thinking, you know, tao lang yan. But anyway,
just to be fair.
At least maliwanag na, simula pa lang. That's clear. Okay.
And so we won't be accused of favoring others. So,
All right.
And then second would be,
it's on the screen.
Customs and
there
traditions. Yeah. That includes festivals, celebrations, like, for instance, Christmas, New Year, and then also nature, travel destinations, flora and fauna, natural resources, even underwater photography. Are you into that?
No, I don't dive. I'm claustrophobic. I can snorkel for a while.
Okay. And the last category is about structures and historical landmarks. That includes heritage sites, also churches, intramuros, corregidor, whatever. But maybe the challenge here is in taking photos, how you can possibly convey a message.
Right.
Not just for the sake of
it's
taking
it's not just it's beautiful, picture. But yes, there's a message with it. All right. Yes. And is that part of your criteria as well? I mean, you have a whole list of criteria as well here. Aside from the theme and the categories, you have specific criteria of how you want or how they will eventually be judged.
Yes. That includes adherence to theme or content, and then creativity, of course, and originality, photographic quality, and visual impact. And of course, we will be seeking the help of experts. Reputable.
You already have a list of judges that you've had in mind?
Yes, we do. Like Wig Dicemans. He was also referred to us by CCP. And since we're not quite familiar with this, it's our first, so it's more prudent to seek the help of also of CCP, which we would like to thank Ms. Boots Herrera for helping us.
All right. And then are you going to ask them to put the blurb, or will you guys put that in eventually to the winning photos? The it's more fun in the Philippines.
Eventually we will do so.
Eventually. Yeah. So they don't have to put it yet.
No, but we will ask them to indicate also the title and caption. Yeah. Just a brief description.
But if they want to put the blurb already, they may want to put it in a specific place. That's part of their creativity. Is that all right?
I guess so. What we are not allowing is to indicate or put their name on the photo.
Okay.
So it's better.
So no watermarking of the photos.
Yeah. Oh, identifying marks.
Yeah, not yet, at least. Okay. Yes. Well, if it's their face or their friend, their family member, you know, that's it. That's for them. All right. And how far down the line do you see this going? I mean, I can sense some really good potential from this. I mean, it's something like could be done year after year, and some more Filipinos can get into photography because the equipment is getting such, you know, so much cheaper nowadays. I mean, before, you know, there's only a niche market of the hobbyist photographers that can buy a good camera. But now, cameras, as I said, with the phones are so nice. Do you see this is something that PAGCOR will retain and probably even enhance in the future?
Yes. Well, last year we started with art competition. Right. This time it's photography. Maybe next year, maybe, I don't know, short films? Or I don't know. But as long as it will support the arts, then.
Definitely. And promoting the Philippines as well.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes,
okay. Yes. Technical details. How do they register? How do they send this? Is it a website or an email?
Yes. First, they have to register online. And then they submit the entries via our website. That is www.pagcor.ph.
All right. And
yes.
Okay. And do the photos have to be taken this year? Or can they be old stock photos that
that they've had have been taken from at the onset of our competition, which started last January 1 until the 20th of May. And it's also open for foreigners.
Okay.
Because we would like to have an idea as to what exactly entice them to come here. So we would have a preview.
Will you have a whole website to show, if not all, most of the photos, not just the winning photos in the end?
I'm sorry?
Will you have a website that you can show
yes, in
all
our website,
of the entries?
Like a gallery. You can put that up.
Yeah, great. All right. I'm excited to see it already. I'll join. Can I join?
Yes.
There's no restrictions to whoever, you know.
18 years old and above.
Okay, 18 years old and above, and then I guess the usual second degree relations to PAGCOR
until third degree of consanguinity. And sorry to fellow PAGCOR employees, you're not allowed.
Not allowed for now. All right, thank you, Maricar. Good to see you. Happy New Year, and thanks for this wonderful competition. We look forward to this.
Thank you also for helping.
Thank you. All right. And folks, those are the latest news alerts for this hour. I'm TJ Manotok on behalf of Lexi Schultz. For more updates, check out our website, ancnews.tv. You can also follow ANC Alerts on Twitter and YouTube and like our Facebook page, ANC 24/7. Stay tuned for Top Story. That's coming up next here on ANC.